The title of the poem is Stay Calm. And the name of the poet is Grenville Glaser. So this is the third unit, but the first poem that we are expected to study in this semester. So let us focus on the title of this particular poem first, before going to the lines in this poem and before just talking about the person who has written this poem. Stay Calm is the title. What do we understand out of the title? Stay calm. Stay calm. Calm simply means silent. Don't react. Stay as you are. Have patience. Right. So whatever situation might you face, you are expected to be in control on yourself. You have to maintain your balance, emotional balance, psychological balance, you have to mention. So Grenville Glaser is a poet who gives a kind of message to the readers that whatever situation you face, you have to stay calm. You have to stay silent. You have to maintain your balance, right? So Grenville Glaser is basically an author of the long list of inspirational books he has written and a number of oratorical success and personality development kind of books he has written, right? So the books that he has written include Inspiration and Ideals, Christ the Master Speaker and more. So during the Great Depression of 1930s, in the 1930s, world faced a Great Depression. So he sent out checks for $1 each enclosed with a note reading to aid business. So he was this kind of person who was, you know, ready to help people in any kind of situation. So during the Depression also, he helped people by giving out whatever he was having with him. So in this particular poem, Stay Calm, Glaser counsels readers to keep calm in the face of many big and small upsets of life. This particular poem is very much appropriate to the present situation of COVID-19, coronavirus. We can relate this poem to the present situation because present situation also is one of the difficult times that we are facing in our life. It is one of the significant phase in our life where we are expected to keep ourselves safe. So this is the situation that is not natural kind of thing. This is the situation when we are in difficulty. So in this type of situation, what Glaser counsels readers is to keep calm when you face difficult situations. Actually, this is the greatness of literature. This is the significance of literature. This is the universality of literature, that any piece of literature does not become outdated. Though this poem was written well before 1935, because Grenville Glaser died in 1935. So it was written even before that, maybe in the first or second decade of 20th century. But the poem is still applicable in India, in Maharashtra, and in the region where you are staying. The poem is still applicable because human beings are expected to face difficulties. Problems are not going to end. If one problem comes to an end today, tomorrow there is some other difficulty that you are going to face. The next day there is one more problem that you are expected to face. So life is full of problems. There are ups and downs that we are going to face in our life. So what Glaser does here is, Glaser tries to counsel readers Kleser tries to give a kind of consolation to the readers to keep calm. He gives a kind of very simple advice to the readers that you have to keep calm, you have to be patient, you have to maintain your balance in the face of many big and small upsets of life. So right now we are experiencing this very big problem in our life, where it is a challenge to be alive. It is a challenge nowadays to be alive, isn't it? If you are alive, if we remain alive, then we can do something tomorrow. So the biggest challenge in front of people today is that to keep themselves safe. People are losing mental balance. People are losing patience. People are thinking that what will happen with us tomorrow is unknown. No? So stating that tranquil temperament is the most potent weapon one can have against adversity. So adversity is difficulty, problem. For example, coronavirus is adversity right now. And that is why we are online. So how we can cope up with this situation, how we can handle this situation with tranquil temperament. Tranquil temperament is the only weapon which is most potent, powerful weapon which we can have in order to fight against the adversity problem. Tranquil temperament is being calm, having patience, not being panic. So temperament is a state of mind, and tranquility is a kind of balance which, you know, saints have, a kind of mentality which people like Sadhgurus have. So tranquil temperament should be maintained. You know, silence should be maintained. Patience should be maintained when we are in such adversity. We are facing adverse situation. So silence is the most important weapon when we face this kind of situations. If we become panic, then it is not going to help us. Right. So let us see what the poet wants to tell us. The poet wants to tell the readers. Right. So let us start analyzing the poem line by line. When you feel like saying something that you know you will regret or keenly feel an insult, not quite easy to forget, that's the time to curb resentment and maintain a mental peace. No, the poet wants to tell the readers that what is the time to maintain the mental peace when we are tend to lose our mental peace because of these reasons. When you feel like saying something, when you feel like saying something to somebody, no, most of the times it so happens with us also that we have a number of things suppressed, buried in our mind, which we want to say to somebody. And after we say, we regret. After we say, we repent, isn't it? So when you feel like saying something that you know you will regret after you say. So if you know that I am going to regret if I say something, the writer wants to tell you that you don't say that thing. You keep that thing in your mind. If you know that you are going to regret, if you are going to repent after you say something, right? Or keenly feel an insult. Sometimes it so happens that somebody insults you. Somebody uses bad words for you. Somebody dishonors you. Somebody abuses you. And you feel keen insult. You feel insulted. And that insult is not easy to forget. Most of the times it so happens, you know, we sometimes forget honor, but we don't forget insult. because these are the words that go deeper in our mind. Insulting words or abusing words remain in our mind, in our brain for longer period, right? So when such things happens with you, when you feel insulted, that's the time to curb resentment. Resentment is anger. When you feel insulted, when somebody insults you, you become angry. But the poet says that this is the time to curb, to control the anger. If you can control the anger this time, then your life is going to be happy. But if somebody insults you and you also cannot control your anger, then life is going to be difficulty for you, because you are going to be a part of a quarrel. You will engage in a quarrel, right? And that will destroy your mental peace, right? So that is the proper time to control your anger and maintain mental peace. If it is possible for you to maintain mental peace when you are going to be angry, then you can lead a happy life, right? For when your mind is tranquil. So why does it happen? When your mind is tranquil, all your ill thoughts simply erase, simply cease. So when your mind is calm, tranquil, when your mind is in proper balance, not angry, no? Or if your mind does not have any bad feelings for others, all your ill thoughts will simply erase, the poet says. All your ill thoughts, all the bad thoughts, bad feelings in your mind will simply cease. Cease simply means come to an end. So when your mind is balanced, calm, there will not be any bad feelings, bad thoughts in your mind. And that is why the poet says, stay calm, stay tranquil, right? It is easy to be angry. To be angry is very easy. No, you cannot be angry with anybody. In your house also, you can be angry with your elder or younger sister, brother. It is very easy to be angry, but it is very difficult to be calm. It is very easy to speak, but it is very difficult to maintain silence. Isn't it? So it is easy to be angry when defrauded or defied. When somebody defrauds you, when somebody cheats you, you know, there are cheaters all around us, because there are several kind of people we meet in our life. So some of them may cheat us, or some of them may defy us, insult us. And if somebody cheats us, if somebody defrauds us, if somebody insults us, we become angry very easily, to be peeved and disappointed. No? Sometimes we become annoyed. We become irritated. Sometimes we become disappointed due to certain incidents that might happen in our life. Isn't it? We expect something from somebody, and if we don't get, if our expectations are unfulfilled, we become disappointed. So when do we become disappointed and annoyed? If your wishes are denied. We have wishes, we have wills, we have expectations. And when the expectations are denied, we feel disappointed, we feel annoyed, peeved, right? But to win a worthwhile battle over selfishness and spite, you must learn to keep strict silence. No? See, using very simple words, the poet is giving us very important advice. What is that advice? When your wishes are denied and when you are disappointed, in order to win a worthwhile battle, isn't it? In order to win the battle that is worthwhile, what is that battle? Battle is not a war that takes place in a war field. It's a battle that takes place within us. It is a battle, it is a war that is within us, within our mind, within our soul. Inner conflict, which is called. So in order to win the battle that is going on in our mind, when somebody insults us or when we are disappointed, isn't it? When we are disappointed, we think deeply why the person behaves with me like this. We are thinking, isn't it? So a kind of inner battle goes on in our mind over selfishness and spite. So we have to win over selfishness. We have to get victory over selfishness. We have to be selfless. We have to conquer spite, hatred. We have to win the hatred which is there in our mind. And once we win, once we have victory over selfishness and spite, what remains in our mind? It remains selflessness. It remains love only in our mind for everybody, isn't it? And how it can be achieved? You must learn to keep strict silence when somebody insults you, when somebody makes you disappointed. It is silence, and not only silence, it is strict silence that you are expected to keep. And then you can overcome any difficulty in your life. Though you know you are in the right position. And very important thing is that though you know that you are right, still you have to be silent. You don't have to try to prove yourself. You don't have to make arguments, because your arguments will not be heard and you will get engaged in a quarrel. You will have to make one argument after another. So instead of making arguments, it is easy to maintain strict silence, to be wise. So keep your mental balance when confronted by a foe. So you are expected to keep your mental balance. You don't have to lose your mental balance. That is, you don't have to be angry or don't get, don't start making arguments. When confronted by a foe. Foe is enemy. So when you meet your enemy in your life, there are some people in our life whom we don't like. So when these people come in front of our eyes, we feel a kind of nervousness. We feel that, I am going to face some difficulty if this person comes in front of our eyes. So when you confront is meet enemies or the people you don't like, sometimes be it enemy in ambush. No, some people are open enemies to you and some people are enemy in ambush. Ambush is hiding, enemy in disguise. These people are very dangerous people. Enemy in ambush are very dangerous people, isn't it? Because open enemy, the people who, are enemies to you, and if they also know, and if you also know that this is my enemy, you can be away. You can be away from that person. You can maintain a kind of safe distance from that person. You can avoid that person. But enemy in ambush cannot be avoided easily, because these kinds of people pretend to be your friends. These kinds of people pretend to be your well-wishers, right? You don't know that this is your enemy. You take that person as your friend, but that person has some kind of grudge for you in their minds, right? So these people, these kinds of people are very dangerous. Or some danger that you know. No? So if you know that some, you are going to face some kind of danger in your life, so that is the time when you are expected to keep your mental balance. That is the time to stay calm. You are not expected to be panic when you say, when you feel that you are going to face danger. If you are poised and tranquil, poised means balanced. Tranquil is calm. So if you are balanced, if you are calm, if you are not irritated, if you are not angry, if you are not panic, when all around is strife. So this is very important. When all around is strife, conflict, struggle. Now there is struggle all around our life. Life is full of struggles and problems, as I have already told you. So it cannot be avoided. Conflict cannot be avoided. Struggle in the life cannot be avoided. If there is no struggle in the life, life will become meaningless. So struggle is a part of our life, which makes life interesting, enjoyable. So when you know that there is struggle all around, and if you are balanced and tranquil, be assured that you have mastered the most vital thing in life. So be assured, tell yourself that I have mastered the life. I have mastered the most important thing in life. I have learned the most important thing in life. When you are balanced in struggle, when you are tranquil in struggle, when you can maintain your psychological balance even in conflict and struggle, tell yourself, be assured that yes, I have mastered, I have learned how to live life. I have learned how to lead successful life, right? So this is all about the poem, Stay Calm. So what do we understand as a message which the poet wants to give us at the end of the poem? That whatever situation you face in your life, whatever struggle you face in your life, you have to maintain your balance. You have to stay calm. You have to stay in a kind of balanced life. Then only you can lead a successful and happy life. Otherwise, life will be very difficult to lead. Right?